Okay, we are going to discuss about the chapter Plant Kingdom, Class 11 NCERT. So without wasting, let's move. So we have to discuss over here the different systems of biological classification. We have three different systems of biological classification, that is artificial system, natural system, and phylogenetic system of classification. Let's discuss each and everything one by one. First is artificial system of classification. It was the earliest system of classification. Artificial system of classification is introduced by Carl Linnaeus. It is based on the vegetative characters or the superficial morphological characters. Okay, they were based on the vegetative character, or you can write vegetative or asexual character. Vegetative or asexual characters are superficial characters, superficial morphological characters. Okay, such as habit, the habitat, then the color, number, and the shape of the leaf. So we are classifying, first we have the artificial system of classification, and it was introduced by the scientist called Carl Linnaeus. It is the earliest system of classification, and it was based on the vegetative character or the superficial morphological character, such as habit, color, number, and the shape of leaf, etc. Linnaeus' artificial system of classification was based on the antrisium structure. Okay, the main important feature for the classification by Linnaeus was based on the antrisium structure. Okay, if this is a stamen, it contains anther and filament. The tissue that joins anther and filament together, you will call it as the connective. Okay, based on the classification of anther, he classified based on the structure of antrisium, he classified, and they are monoadelphous, diadelphous, if only one group. Diadelphous means two group. Polyadelphous means many group. Okay, synanthrous, gynanthrous, didynanthrous, etc. This is based on the type of stamens, and this is what about the artificial system of classification. Next is, what are the drawbacks of the artificial system of classification? So artificial system was the first classification that came into existence, and it was put forth by a scientist, that is Carl Linnaeus, already explained. After the artificial system of classification, only natural system of classification took its place. What are the major drawbacks of artificial system of classification? They separated the closely related species since they were based on a few characters. Since this artificial system of classification was based on only a few characters, it just separated apart certain organisms which are closely related. Or the closely related species were taken apart because this was based on a few characters. Equal weightage to vegetative and sexual characteristics was not given. Vegetative and, that is, asexual characters and sexual character were given equal weightage. Is it contains equal weightage? No. Sexual reproduction is more complex than asexual type. This is not acceptable, as vegetative characters are most easily affected by the environment. Okay, vegetative characters are more easily affected by the environment, and these two were the major drawbacks of artificial system of classification. Clear? Next, we have the natural system of classification. The natural system of classification given by the scientists George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker. That is, simply you will tell it as the Bentham and Hooker's classification, or the natural system of classification. These were based on natural affinities among organism. They were based on natural affinities among the organism. And the most important feature is that, or the advanced feature from artificial was that it considers both external and internal features. This particular system considers both external features as well as internal features, that is anatomy, morphology, embryology, phytochemistry, and ultrastructure. Ultrastructure, anatomy, embryology, and phytochemistry. And the classification of flowering plants by this natural system of classification is credited to George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker. Last but not the least, you have the phylogenetic system of classification. Phylogenetic system of classification, look, it was based on the common evolutionary relationship. So the type of classification which was based on the evolutionary relationship among the organism is known as phylogenetic system of classification. And this assumes that the organisms in the same taxa have a common ancestor. Look, apes, gorillas, monkeys, orangutans, all these have a common ancestor. Okay, common ancestor for all these organisms. This assumes that the organisms in the same taxa have a common ancestor. Clear? Next is, what are the other sources to resolve the problem of classification? And there comes the importance of three important taxonomies: numerical taxonomy, cytotaxonomy, and chemotaxonomy. All these three terms are very important, and it is there in your NCERT. Numerical taxonomy is based on all observable character. Not much important, but they can be asked. Numerical taxonomy is based on the observable characteristic. It is carried out using computers. Number and codes are assigned to all characters and data are processed. The hundreds of characters are equally considered at the same time. So the important points that you have to know from here is that numerical taxonomy is based on the observable characteristic. Numerical taxonomy is based on the observable characters. It is done by using computers, and certain digits and numbers or codes were assigned to all the characters. And data were equally processed, and at the same time, hundreds of different characters can be considered. Cyto means cell. So cytotaxonomy refers to the, which is based on the cytological information like chromosome number, its structure, behavior, etc. And that is cytotaxonomy. Last but not the least, it is a chemotaxonomy. It uses the chemical constituents of the plant to classify the organism. Okay, so in the previous slides, we have discussed about artificial classification. Artificial system of classification, important points to ponder is, it was introduced by Carl Linnaeus. It was based only on the vegetative or asexual or the superficial morphological characters such as habit, shape of the leaf, color, and number of leaf. It was based, Linnaeus' classification was based on the andrecium structure. This is a 10 times at least. 10 times repeated neat question. That is, name the mode or system of classification in which andrecium, or name the scientist who classified the plants based on the andrecium structure. It was called Linnaeus, and the system was artificial system of classification. And its disadvantage is that different organisms were made together and closely related species were set apart. And equal weightage was given for both vegetative and sexual characteristics. Next is, natural system of classification is based on the natural affinities among the organism. It considered external features and internal features. And it was put forth by Bentham and Hooker, Joseph Dalton Hooker and George Bender. Bentham and Hooker's system of classification. Last, we have the phylogenetic system of classification based on the common evolutionary descent, and the organism occupying the same taxa same taxa are having a common ancestor. Are having a common ancestor. Okay. Then we discussed about numerical taxonomy, cytotaxonomy, and last is a chemotaxonomy. This is how you classify. This is an example or how we do numerical taxonomy. And this is cytotaxonomy. And this is chemotaxonomy. Okay. In the next class, we will be discussing about the basic concepts of algae.